going to sort of start off from here and then follow.
Are we all going to be wearing masks or?
I think of people's own volition.
About 3 years. As you go from here, is that all right?
Sure.
I will be here singing as well.
Thanks, David.
Okay, so just sing nice and loud from here.
So I've got a feeling you're in one of these ones. secure a bit because I don't want to be chatting in the chat. On Saturday the 30th, I was going to change some stuff in the afternoon because we've got one of our local artists who's done a popping.
All right.
And we've got a little crochet he's going in as well. So we're turning it into a cool pop effects. So, when we come out, we're gonna gather in.
bunging table. It's probably got a better liturgy name to it.
And hope, and the microphone will be there.
Yeah.
Oh, so nice and loud.
Okay.
Peace and hope.
Yep.
All right, well done. And then you'll
go back to stats.
Thank you.
over here.
Oh, lucky me.
Who haven't I got you?
Good evening, everybody, and a very warm welcome to St. Clement's. It is our custom here to prepare ourselves before our services, and you'll notice that the order of service begins where it says music before Mass, Salvation Army band, check, outside, and I'm very grateful to Salvation Army. We're going to, in a minute, sing the gathering hymn, and then if you are able just to spend some time in remembrance before this Requiem Mass. I'm very grateful to everybody who has gathered to join us this evening, and I pray that this will not only be a good time of remembrance and prayer for St. David and for his family, but also a chance for us as a community to bind ourselves together in the face of this terrible event. So if you are able, please stand for the gathering hymn, Christ Be Our Light. Please do be seated. So we gather in a time of relative silence as we prepare for this service. order of service continues on page 9 in your blue Mass book. I know that my Redeemer lives, and on the last day I shall rise again. In my body I shall look on God my Saviour. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you. It is a great privilege to be able to gather here with my brothers and sisters in the faith from across Leigh and from representatives of the council and various other of the organisations and parts of the life of this town and the constituency. We have all responded in our own and different ways, and it is good for us to be able to gather in this place together. We know that the world is not as we think it should be. We are shocked. We are amazed. We are hurt by the brokenness and the violence we see around us. And yet we know that we all fall short. So at the top, the second confession on page 10, we confess our sins. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life everlasting. Through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Christ have mercy, Christ have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Let us pray. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, whom you raised from the dead. Strengthen our faith that David and all who have died in the love of Christ will share in his resurrection. Who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
We sit to hear the words of Holy Scripture, which may be followed in your service sheet.
A reading from the Book of Lamentations. My soul is bereft of peace. I have forgotten what happiness is. So I say, gone is my glory. And all that I had hoped for from the Lord, the thought of my affliction and my homelessness is wormwood and gall. My soul continually thinks of it and is bowed down within me. But this I call to mind, and therefore I have hope. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Great is your faithfulness. The Lord is my portion, says my soul. Therefore, I will hope in him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have died. For since death came through a human being, the resurrection of the dead has also come through a human being. For as all die in Adam, so all will be made alive in Christ, but each to his own order. Christ, the first fruits, then at his coming, those who belong to Christ. And then comes the end, when he hands over the kingdom to God the Father, after he has destroyed every ruler, every authority, and every power. For he must reign until he has put all his enemies under his feet. The last enemy to be destroyed is death. For God has put all things in subjection under his feet. When it says all things are put in subjection, it is plain that it does not include the one who put all things in subjection under him. When all things are subjected to him, then the Son himself will also be subjected to the one who put all things in subjection under him, so that God may be all in all. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Lord be with you.
And also
with you. We stand to hear the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If you know me, you will know my Father also. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. If you love me, you will keep my commandments. And I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, because he abides with you, and he will be in you. I have said these things to you while I am still with you, but the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
The Holy Gospel, free us from our sins.
Please sit down. Let not your hearts be troubled. Now, in this context, as we're gathered here this evening, you might say, Andrew, really? You might think to say, well, David has been taken from us, and it's shocking. And it's disturbing. And you're telling us, let not your hearts be troubled. And yet, friends, these are important and real, substantive words for us to know and believe as Christian people. Because the reality of death is all around us. And to have someone like David die in these circumstances, well, that brings death all too close. Jesus' statement here, in the context of the discussion he's in, is about the life that is to come. It's one that recognizes human emotion behind the shock. Here we see the humanity of Jesus as he understands, and the divinity of Jesus as he reveals his place in the Godhead, the Trinity. As we reflect on David's life, it was full, as we all know, of family and friends, of devotion to his role, his calling, to our community, to his faith. But he was also about smiles and laughter and jokes. A love given, a love received, compassion, service, sacrifice, joy and pain, humility. And I would take nothing away from the grief and sadness that many of us have felt. I can't say everything is all right because it is not. And we know that. And we're shocked. And we are hurt. And we are bewildered. And these emotions will be with David's family and our community for a long time. God made us so that we can have relationships with one another. And when one of those relationships is lost, we feel pain. We lost David, and it hurts for many of us. But yet, there is celebration even here. There is thanksgiving even here as we give thanks for David, as he was someone who enriched and affected our lives. He reflected something of God, as we all do. So how do we respond? Well, there are words of comfort in this passage. We sung them in our preparation and gathering him. Because peace is promised. Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In the midst of our sadness and bewilderment, we can have peace. Why? Because many of us, like David, have a faith that speaks of peace. Christians believe that even in the most difficult of times and emotions, there is the chance of peace. We can know peace. And because we know that God is with us, we can have that peace. The 23rd Psalm says this too. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me.
God is present. His peace is here. And in the rubble of pain and anguish, God is here. But there's also a message of hope. Our best efforts, our plans and desires may be shattered by violence, but hope means that there's always a future. Whatever situation we're in, because God graciously promised to never leave us. By faith, we trust Jesus' words, and that leads to hope. I trust that all of us gathered here this evening to come and share in this celebration and thanksgiving and remembrance of David's life, that we will hear the reassuring message of God, a message that David knew and cherished, a message lived out in his own life. We exist in a challenging and a changing world. And David knew that, and like all of us, he lived it. Where things don't always go to plan, where there is the pleasant, unexpected turn of events, as well as tragedy. We hear loud and clear the request of David's family to set aside hatred and work towards togetherness. That's something of peace, but also of hope. The message and promise of God is that he is with us in all of this, all of life and love, work and indeed death. Is there anyone here to help us? Well, God's promise is that he is always there. And he surrounds us with his generous care and grace. Christ is the way, the truth, and the life. There's a contemporary song that we sing in our church with these words. You gave life. You are love. You bring light to the darkness. You give hope. You restore every heart that is broken. And great are you, Lord. So show us, Lord, that love and light, that peace and hope that can't be measured. Eternity can't be weighed, just lived. Put a little of those things in us this evening, we ask. Amen.
In the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ Jesus, let us pray to the Father.
After each section, if you would like to follow the response, hear our prayers. Let us pray. Into your hands, O Lord, we have entrusted David. In this life, you embraced him with your tender love. We thank you that David knew you, loved you, worshipped you, and sought to do your will. We thank you that you welcome him into your eternal presence. You welcome him into your paradise where there is no sorrow, no weeping, no pain, no regret. You welcomed him into the fullness of peace and joy with your Son and the Holy Spirit forever and ever. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayers.
Lord, God of love and compassion, we lift the family of David to you. We pray for Julia and all the children, and we pray for the wider family, and we pray for David's office staff and colleagues here in this borough and in Westminster. We pray that in their grief, their deep pain and loss, they will know your presence, your comfort, your healing. We pray you will watch over their hearts and minds and that you will continue to fill them with your peace and your Spirit, the Comforter. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, have mercy on all those who mourn the loss of their friend, the loss of their colleague. Draw near to those who feel numb and crushed and are filled with the pain of grief, whose strength has given up. You know all our sighing and longings. Be near to us and teach us to fix our hope on you. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We pray for each other at this time of grief. May we be held by the God of compassion as we remember our dear friend David this evening and in the days ahead. May God be with us in our sorrow, comfort us in our loss. May God give us strength and confidence. May our spirits be lifted. May our hearts be filled with his peace. And may the light of God's promise fill us with hope for the future. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Dearest Jesus, who wept at the death of your friend and taught us that those who mourn shall be comforted, grant us the comfort of your presence in our deep loss. Send your Holy Spirit to direct us, lest we make hasty or foolish decisions. Send your Spirit to give us courage, lest through fear we recoil from living. Send your Spirit to bring us your peace, lest bitterness or regret take root in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord Jesus, our Redeemer, our Saviour, our Lord, you willingly gave yourself up to death so that all people might be saved and pass from death into a new life. Listen now to the cries of our hearts. Look with love and compassion on all your people who mourn. Lord Jesus, you alone are holy and compassionate, and forgive us our sins. By dying and rising from the dead, you open the gates of eternal life for those who believe in you. We thank you, our dear friend David is with you forever. He has heard you say, "Well done, good and faithful servant." We live as aliens and strangers in this world, but those whose faith is in you live for another kingdom, an eternal kingdom where you rule and reign in glory and majesty. We are thankful David is now in that new kingdom with you forever. The loss and sadness is ours, but your peace comes with healing in its wings. We ask for healing for the hearts and comfort for the soul. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Finally, we pray for the people of our borough. Lord, we ask that in your mercy you would reach out to the people of our borough. We pray that by your Spirit you would make yourself known, that your glorious gospel would be shared, and that the people of our borough would come into a saving knowledge of the Lord Jesus. We pray for this blessing of new life in Jesus for our borough. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
And we offer these prayers to you, mighty God, in the wonderful name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. As we prepare for the piece, I am delighted that the Music Man Project is here to help us in that preparation.
Just while we're waiting to set up, I've spoken a lot about Sir David over the past few days, but the one thing I want to say is that Sir David believed in all of us, and that is why we are very honoured to perform a song called Peace and Hope.
and hope, fire and love, peace and trust, faith and peace. Amen.
As you go, like an everlasting friend. Time to love is all too brief. Give some love, receive belief.
Belief
be with you as you go, like an everlasting friend. One more friend is still a must. Belief is nothing without trust. Trust be with you as you go, like an everlasting friend. Strong, reliable and safe. Now you're ready to find faith.
Fire and love, believe.
peace and hope, fire and love, belief and trust, faith and peace, Father, Son, Amen.
Wasn't your signing and singing beautiful? I think you should have another round of applause. And so I would invite you, if you are able, to stand for the peace. In all cultures and in most Christian liturgies, there is a time at which we acknowledge that we are to be at peace with one another. And in this tradition, we do it just before the breaking of the bread. I will say, peace be with you, and you say, and also with you, if you're feeling so moved. And because of COVID, we're no longer shaking hands. But if you just nod to the people around you as a sign that we are one family of God's children at peace with one another. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. So we remain standing for our offertory hymn, Abide With Me. This Mass continues on page 18, at the top of page 18 in the blue book. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that this my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Lord, in your mercy, may this sacrifice of praise, this offering of peace, bring our brother David to the fullness of risen life. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
The Lord be with you. And also with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and good, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord. In him who rose from the dead, a hope of resurrection dawned. The sadness of death gives way to the bright promise of immortality. Lord, for your faithful people, life is changed and not ended. When the body of our earthly dwelling lies in death, we gain an everlasting dwelling place in heaven. And so, with all the choirs of angels in heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name and join in their unending hymn of praise. How wonderful the work of your hands, O Lord. As a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embraced a people as your own. When they turned away and rebelled, your love remained steadfast. From them you raised up Jesus, our Saviour, born of Mary, to be the living bread in whom all our hungers are satisfied. He offered his life for sinners, and with a love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms on the cross. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you these gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he came to supper with his friends, and taking bread, he gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
at the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, to shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Father, we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. And we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. As we eat and drink these holy things in your presence, form us in the likeness of Christ, and build us into a living temple to your glory. Remember, Lord, your church in every land. Reveal her unity, guard her faith, and preserve her in peace. Bring us at the last with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles Clement and all the saints, to that vision of that eternal splendor for which you have created us, through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, with whom, and in whom, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honor and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. In the dignity of God's love for each of us, we stand as we pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ.
Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. In this ongoing time of COVID pandemic, those of you who wish to receive Holy Communion, and you are very welcome to do so, will be receiving Holy Communion in one kind only. If you're in the north aisle or the nave, please do be seated, and you will be directed to come up at the appropriate time. If you do not want to receive Holy Communion or are unable to do so because of your faith and belief, but would like a blessing, please make the sign of the cross like this so that we know to bless you. And if you would really rather not receive communion, either stay where you are or just keep your head down and we'll know to pass on by without any comment or worry. If you're in the south aisle, Holy Communion will be brought to you over there. And there are stewards around the church who will help you get to where you need to go. If you're in the choir, you'll be receiving communion as usual in the Resurrection Chapel. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. If anyone believes in me, even though he dies, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Please do be seated. Corpus Christi. Sanguinis Christi.
bless you.
Let us pray. Gracious God, we thank you that in your great love you have fed us with the spiritual food of the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, and has given us a foretaste of your heavenly banquet. Grant that this sacrament may be to us a comfort in affliction and a pledge of our inheritance in that kingdom where there is no death, neither sorrow nor crying, but fullness of joy with all the saints, through Jesus Christ, our Saviour. Amen. I'd like to repeat my thanks to all of you who have been able to attend, either on your own behalf or representing various parts of the life of the community of Leigh and the wider borough. We come now to the lighting of candles of hope, and more people have come forward to light candles than we have candles prepared. So if you aren't called forward, please don't take this as a personal affront, for this is representative of the life of our community, not an inexhaustible list of everything that happens. The idea, as we began with the gathering hymn, the idea of there being light in darkness, is that as we go from this place, having offered this Mass for the repose of the soul of David, that we take the hope of God's love out into this community and the wider world, knowing that it is only by love, mercy, compassion, and forgiveness that the world can live at peace. I'm sure many of you have heard the words that Julia Amess has said, that the violence must stop. And so, we have a moment of meditation as I will invite various representatives of our local community to come forward to light candles on behalf of the whole community. Leigh Town Council. I'm sure I saw someone from the Borough Council, Ashley. The Royal British Legion, Leeds Branch. Stibbard's representing the business community. Sarah Cox representing the charitable sector. Uniformed organizations. Just light one candle between you. Our schools. Our universities and colleges. For the children. For the Methodist community, especially for Belfast Methodist. For Sir David's Catholic community. Churches together in Leigh. The book of condolence is still at the back of church. There are a lot of you, so if you can't get to sign it today, the church is open again tomorrow morning. Obviously, you may well have gone to the Civic Centre. There are other books of condolence. Thank you again for your attendance and for your involvement, and may you have a blessed night. We stand for the final blessing. The Lord be with you. Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. May the God of all mercy and compassion wipe away every tear from your eyes and give you the courage, the comfort, the strength and you love and the love you need this night and in the days to come. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be upon you this day and always. Amen. The Mass is ended. Go in peace. And so we sing our final hymn.
there. Do you know you
Ralphie.
Well done, thank you.
Yeah.
Thanks, Marcus.
Cheers.
See you soon.
Yeah.
Yes, it is. As the main church of Leigh, isn't it? It's the Leigh church. Yeah, exactly. But it's lovely that every single denomination is represented at the service. It's the first shot we've had today.
Some